Hey, what's going on everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another Launchbox tutorial. Today, this is going to be a quick one, but I wanted to kind of get this out of the way because it's a question that comes up quite a lot. And while I'm scrolling through here, you might notice I do have a couple games here missing some box art. Looks like GoldenEye and F-Zero X. It's not spelled correctly. And this is where the main issue comes in. Correct game names so they match the Launchbox games database. So you might not even see some of these, you know, unpopulated games here, because from your view section, hide games, you may have something enabled here, missing videos, missing front box image. If I go ahead and enable this, it's going to go ahead and take that game right out of here. We're not going to see it. But I've got all of these unchecked so we can see all of the games that are missing metadata. As you can see when I click on it, we just kind of get a generic box up here. Same thing with GoldenEye. Now, it's very important to have the correct game name. And one easy way to find the correct game name or the correct layout that we need to use to correct this is to actually head over to the Launchbox Games database. I'll leave a link for this in the description. We're going to start here with GoldenEye. This is one that didn't scrape correctly. GoldenEye, definitely not the correct name. I mean, it's really close. But if we head over to the Launchbox Games database and search up GoldenEye, we can see a list of all of the platforms that have this game, and we're going with the N64 version. So if we take a look at the name, GoldenEye 007, we also have an alternative name, 007 GoldenEye. So it can actually be named either of these to scrape correctly. Now this is just an easy way to do it. We're going to go ahead and copy this name here. We're going to head back over to Launchbox. I'm going to right click on this game. I'm going to edit, edit metadata and media. And from the title of the game here, I'm going to go ahead and paste the correct name in. You can type this out if you want to, GoldenEye 007. So we've got the correct name, but in order to rescrape it or search for metadata, all we need to do is search right here. And as you can see, it matched up with an entry from the Launchbox Games database. So we'll go ahead, select that one. We've got the release date, release type, genre. Everything about the game will be populated here, but again, we didn't scrape the images. So from this same section here, edit metadata and media, images, download media, and now it can scrape it correctly. So from the Launchbox Games database, I'm gonna leave everything checked here. EMU movies, same thing. We're gonna check all, and we're gonna download all of that artwork. We'll choose okay. Now our game is set up correctly. Let's do it one more time with F-Zero X. So obviously it is misspelled here. We're just gonna head back over to the Launchbox Games database and we can actually just search for F-Zero. So we've got the SNES version of F-Zero, but we're actually working with the N64 version, F-Zero X, N64. And as you can see, we've got the name here, and there's also an alternative name, and this is the Chinese name. And as you can see, we've got the correct name. We've also got an alternate name. So this just makes it really easy to get the right name that we're going to be able to scrape this with correctly the first time. So again, from that game, right click, we're going to edit, edit metadata and media. Very top, I'm just going to paste it in. I'm going to search for metadata. Came right up for me. Now, we want to get our images, download media. I'm going to go with EMU Movies and the Launchbox Games database. Choose download. Okay. And there we have it. So we've corrected those two titles that didn't scrape correctly due to the wrong name of the ROM itself. And this is really where it comes down. 99.9% of the time, if something doesn't scrape correctly, it is the name of the game that's incorrect. Before I wrap this video up, there's one last thing I want to talk about here when it comes to naming your ROMs or ROM names, and that's extra information. As long as that extra information is in parentheses, Launchbox is going to be totally fine with it. So for instance, when I say extra information, I'm talking about region or version. So for most of my Super Nintendo games, you can see that we've got a parentheses, USA parentheses. As long as those are there, Launchbox is going to know exactly what we're talking about here. It could also be a version, like V1, V2, V3. Going down the list here, you can see we've got parentheses Europe parentheses. When it comes down to your game collection, you may see this quite a bit. But as long as those are in parentheses, the region or the version of the game, Launchbox is going to be fine with it. Just keep that in mind. But that's going to wrap it up for this one, and hope this helped you out. Definitely stay tuned to the YouTube channel and the Launchbox forum, because we've got a lot coming. And like always, thanks for watching.